What's up, guys? So, okay. So, you have a question. Okay, may question si Sir Jomar. Okay? And then, insight naman ni Sir Joshua. Okay? So, let me give it to you. Okay? So, Coach, pwede po bang pa-explain yung recording ni ICT about dun sa Advanced VPR? Di ko po masyado na-gets kung ano po yung sinasabi niya sa video. Yung nasa 6 minutes po na video, Coach. Thanks. Okay? So, okay. Let's explain this one now. Okay? Before that, so, let's go to our Google Drive first. There you go. Ayan. So, ito po yun, ha. So, itong advanced price delivery range. Ito yung video na yun. So, if malilito kayo, then definitely go watch this pang 30th video natin explaining the advanced VPR. Okay? So, let's go to this 6-minute video.
That's the close and open of that candle. The small little variance in price, you have to allow for that.
Now, ano ginawa niya? Nakita, tinignan niya yung alin? BPR or yung BC and CB, which is the huge candlestick, tama? And there you go. You have it right around here. Now, naglagay siya ng Fibonacci inside of that zone. Bakit? He wants the price to what? Deliver and reprice. Balikan yung zones na yan. Pero kung titignan ninyo, naglagay siya ng Fibonacci. There you go. Naglagay siya ng Fibonacci dito. Highs and lows. Take a look at the 4100.75. Hindi nag-open above ng 50% zone or consequent encouragement yung previous, yung latest price range. Ibig sabihin yung bagong price, hindi siya nag-open 50%. So in that case, possible, this is an, what? BPR, if and only if umalis siya dyan, tama? If and only if umalis siya dito sa zones na to, then masasabi natin siyang BPR. Now, tignan nyo.
Don't let that scare you. Don't let it be a source of fear.
So, wag ka daw matakot na umaangat ang presyo saan? Sa potential BPR mo. Bakit? It's normal due to that 50% consequent encouragement or CE.
Or anxiety. That's normal. That's a normal thing in price delivery. So now, price goes up into that area. We want to see, and I would be saying, if we were doing a live trade, I'd say, we want to see it deliver and go lower now. It goes down.
So, ano sabi? Diba dito, BPR, okay? Right around here. Nakita niyo yung 50% level of consequent encouragement right around here. So, the moment na tinamaan na yung 50% niya, ano gusto niyo mangyari? Siyempre, iwan niya na yan. Umalis ka na dyan. Para what? Para masabi mong anin, balance na po ito. Or balance price range na po ito. Naiintindihan? Para masabing balance na po ito, kailangan umalis ng presyo. Diba? Tulad ng sinabi ko sa inyo. Okay? Now, ano mangyari? Once na umalis yan dyan, ano ay kikreate? Break of structure. Right around here. Okay? The moment na nagkaroon tayo ng break of structure right around here, ito yung unang BPR ninyo. Then, ito, at saka ito, right around here, tingnan natin yung explanation ni ICT.
What's it doing here? It takes out this low here. So now, this low to this high here becomes what? A bounce price range. Because the market has delivered both directions of buy side and sell side.
Ano sabi? This is balanced price range kasi dineliver ang both sides of the market, buy side and sell side. Ano ginawa? Right around here, the BPR, the balanced price range, sell side, buy side, upper both sides. Meron ka sell side dito, buy side. Okay? Down, up, down, break of structure. Itong whole market na to, nag-deliver siya ng what? Balanced price. Kasi nga, umalis na yung price. So, in that case, masasabi nyo to as what? Your balanced price range. Possible, this is your balanced price range. Okay? Nakapag-deliver siya ng both sides of the market. Buy side, umangat yung market, papunta doon sa consequent encouragement, and then sell side, right around here. Balanced price range to magiging isang buo na to.
Between this here, the RL range, down to this low here, the market trades back up to what?
Buy
consequent
side.
Encouragement. So consequent encouragement becomes the high end of the new balance price range. because when you trace back that far, there's no need to worry back to here or this old low. It's already done its work by going back and forth between these two candles. Think about that paint analogy. Are you going to paint the same section of the wall 5 times?
Ibig sabihin, guys, hindi nyo na kailangan pang isipin yung prices babalik pa dito or babalikan pa yung order block nyo somewhere around above, and this is your pair body gap kung babalikan pa ba itong mga zones na to or even in these zones. Why? This is enough. Enough na to.
No, you're wasting paint. Price isn't going to waste time. Time is important to it. It only has so many trading hours in the day. So you take your eye and your attention. You don't want to do this when price is trading live because you'll miss what you're supposed to be focusing on. But you want to be referring to it while watching price. So again, we're thinking
sell side.
We're thinking that the price is going to continuously go lower. The market trades back up into this consequent correction here, which is now the new high of the balance price range. There's no necessity for it to trade higher. Does the willingness of price reflect wanting to go lower? Yes, it does. It takes out this low here, and then we come back up. What's permissible? If this is a balanced price range, it's painted price down, offered sell side, then it offered buy side to the area where we're expecting to see price go to anyway. Then it should go lower. It does. It leaves that price range. Can it go back up into this range? Yes. How far? Halfway. Because we're measuring bodies, we're looking at it through the lens of what? Mean threshold.
Ibig sabihin, once na nakuha nyo yung balance price range nyo right around here, okay, pwedeng bumalik agad yung price, and guess what? Diba sabi ko nga sa inyo, it will stand for what? Brick wall. It will go, or it will serve as your brick wall. Okay? Now, ang tanong, ano sabi ni ICT, gaano daw bang kahaba? Or saan pupunta yung direction? Halfway. Ibig sabihin, from 50% consequent encouragement, 0.25 will do so. Naiintindihan? 0.25, ano yun, Sir Kim? 0.25. Lagay ka dito ng Fibonacci, 50, from top or highs to lows, and then, yung 50% consequent encouragement na makikita mong line dyan, lagyan mo ulit ng highs and lows, and then yung 50 mo na makikita dito, that will be your 25%. That's your halfway to the 50%. Okay? So in that case, Sir Kim, pwede ba namin i-trade yun? Yes. In that case, tingnan mo kung makikita mo naman sa 5 minutes chart or higher time frame, may makikita dyan per valley gap right around here. Okay? In order for it to go short. Ganun lang.
Man, I should have charged you money for this. So here is the mean threshold. 4097.50. That's what could reasonably be traded to, and it's permissible. It means
permissible, it means from low to high, pwede daw pong pumunta pa dito yung presyo on the 50% zone. Pero ang pinakamagandang position na sinabi ni ICT is halfway. Possible yung 25% papunta dito.
Allowed. You can expect that and it doesn't upset anything. The market fails to go there. What does it do? It trades lower than that low now. So we're expanding our range and it breaks lower. We don't even need to go back up to mean threshold. We're looking for now any further advancement lower. What is this area here now we come? Between mean threshold, which was never hit, this to this is your new balance price range. Does market want to trade away from that? It does. But now we're late in the day. What time of day? 15:24, so it's 24 minutes after 3, New York local time. It's going to run. It's going to aggressively reach to the liquidity it's going to aim for the day. It aggressively runs, trades to whatever 40, 70 and a quarter becomes. I don't even know what that is. I thought, hey, in my notes, that jog my memory to that. It hits it at what time? 15:34, so 34 minutes after 3.
Okay, so then, anyways, throughout the video, explain niya na lang dito yung time relativity or the macro time session. Okay? Pero, you know, you get it. So, I hope na intindihan nyo yung BPR. So, again, may tips din sa inyo si Joshua. No? Sabi niya, yung advanced BPR coach, ang naiisip ko doon is the whole market is parang BPR. Yes. Okay? Ang BPR para sa akin, okay? Ang BPR is para siyang order block or supply and demand zone. Same treatment. Okay? Pero hindi sila parehas. Pero sa akin, same treatment silang dalawa. Okay? So, yun lang yung naiisip ko dun sa BPR na yan. The whole market consists of BPR, correct? The whole market consists of what? Supply and demand. Okay? So, I hope naintindihan ninyo yung BPR. So, again, ito yan, kasimple. Okay? So, I hope naintindihan nyo tong 6-minute video ni ICT explaining the BPR. Okay? So, yeah, thank you so much. See you again next time. Peace.